Welcome to the Let's Try series, where I try to do something new at least once a month. In this video, I decided to try out streaming and recording gameplay. I gotta say, my first experience streaming felt like I was basically just playing the game and not really doing anything different. Of course, there would be a much larger difference if I had people watching my stream and if I interacted with those people. But for this one, I was still sort of figuring things out. My Twitch account is Scotty Lou if you want to follow me. Honestly, don't know if I'll be streaming in the future since I don't really play games that often, but if I do, I'll try to pre-plan it and maybe tweet about it or something. Anyways, so the first time I streamed was by myself, and then another time I streamed was with another friend, and that time was a lot more fun, but I think it's just because I have more fun playing with other people. So yeah, if you don't really have people watching, streaming is basically the same as just playing the game, except the difference is that if you do want to get viewers and stuff, you will have to basically talk and sort of give a performance almost. One thing I considered doing since I'm interested in voice acting was acting out the dialogue from the Paper Mario scenes, which is the game I streamed. That would have been interesting and definitely different. So it's really down to your creativity to make the streaming experience more interesting. In terms of recording gameplay and then editing it, I actually did that for the Overcooked ones since I am super proud that we got some 4 stars. The editing process was sort of like editing a Blue Lotus video, which is my movie anime podcast with my friends. You just gotta clean up the audio, cut out parts that aren't really necessary, and kablam, you got your basic playthrough video. I did spice things up by creating a compilation type video with my favorite moments in the session. For that one, I actually very much enjoyed doing that because it was pretty fun sifting through and seeing our dumb mistakes. Overall, I can't really see myself doing this as a hobby or as a frequent thing since I don't really want to add an extra thing on my plate which already has many, many things on it. I think I wouldn't mind the streaming aspect of it though, since you don't really have to edit that much, and it's more of a live performance type thing which definitely has a lot more room for creativity. So I'll see if I want to do more with that in the future. If you guys are interested in streaming or recording gameplay, it's pretty easy. Just download Streamlabs OBS, look up some tutorial on how to optimize the settings, connect to your Twitch, and then play the game. Luckily, my friend had an Elgato capture device to connect to the Switch, which allowed me to record the Switch gameplay. All you really need in terms of equipment is a decent mic, a decent computer to run Streamlabs, and decent internet. You'll probably need a better computer if you're playing a PC game though, but it is pretty simple. The hardest part is the mental aspect. Just consider your first try a test run and ask 3 really close friends to watch the stream and give you feedback. Luckily, I had 3 of my cousins watch the stream, so I didn't exactly have 0 watchers, even though they just left it on the background. Thanks, guys. Anyways, if anybody watching this video wants to play a game together, just comment below and let me know which game, and I'll see if I can make it happen. Quarantine has forced me to socialize more with people online, but once it's over, it'll be really fun to just try new things for the series and just go all out with the filming of it. Just gotta be patient and try things I can do indoors with nobody around. Anyways, if you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing and giving the video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great day.